Good morning. My name is David Oxtoby. As president of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, it's my pleasure to welcome you to today's event marking the publication of a new American Academy report, Science During Crisis, Best Practices, Research Needs, and Policy Priorities. This report builds on a recent workshop convened by the American Academy to explore how scientific expertise could be more productively incorporated into the immediate response to disasters. As you will hear from today's speakers, there have been many studies on the use of science to predict and prepare for a wide range of crises, from hurricanes to wildfires to landslides and other events. But the role of scientists is not limited to forecasting, preparation, or long-term recovery. Science has a role to play in the immediate hours following the onset of a crisis, and we will hear several real-world examples from today's speakers. As you will hear, there's certainly room to improve how scientists are employed in times of crisis, from the development of best practices to policy changes that would facilitate their involvement. Our speakers will highlight several recommendations from our new report and will also discuss areas in which more research is urgently needed. Today, you will hear from three distinguished individuals, each of whom has extensive experience in dealing with disasters. We will first hear from the co-authors of the report, Rita Colwell and Gary Maclis. The brief biographies on the back of your program do not begin to do justice to their remarkable careers, so I will add a few details. Dr. Colwell is a renowned microbiologist who, among many other accomplishments, made significant advances to our understanding of the life cycle of cholera and means of combating it, particularly in developing countries. She's an elected member of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, as well as the scientific academies of the US and several other countries, and has served as president of several scientific societies. Rita has received an impressive list of awards for scientific research and leadership, including the National Medal of Science in 2006, the Japanese Order of the Rising Sun, the Stockholm Water Prize, and just last year, the Lee Kuan Yew Water Prize. She is a former director of the National Science Foundation and currently holds the title of Distinguished University Professor at the University of Maryland. Her co-author, Gary Maclis, is University Professor of Environmental Sustainability at Clemson University. He previously served as science advisor to the director of the U.S. National Park Service and simultaneously as co-chair of the Interior Department's Strategic Sciences Group, which has responsibility to conduct interdisciplinary science-based assessments during national environmental crises. He's an elected fellow of the American Association for the Advancement of Science, among other honors. Dr. Maclis was a recipient of the Department of Interior's 2000 Conservation Service Award, one of the highest civilian awards granted by the department. His research has spanned a wide range of issues, from applying human ecology to conserving national parks, to the environmental impacts of warfare, and advancing a science capacity in Haiti after the devastating earthquake in 2010. Following the two authors, we will then hear from Brad Kaiserman, Vice President for Disaster Operations and Logistics at the American Red Cross. Prior to joining the Red Cross in 2015, he held several executive positions at FEMA, including Assistant Administrator for Recovery and Chief Counsel. He also previously served as Associate General Counsel for Operations and Enforcement at the Department of Homeland Security. He served in the Coast Guard in various civilian and military capacities for 22 years, including as commanding officer of a patrol boat. Brad, it's an honor to include you on today's program as well, and I look forward to hearing your reaction to the report. Following the speakers, we will open the floor for questions. So thank you for coming. Let me turn the podium over to Rita Colwell.